Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. We're going to try to make a silver crossbow. Maybe Gulliver can help with that.
Gulliver!
Yes?
Crossbow bolt. Not a silver crossbow. I found a broken loam press in the woods. Can you repair it? So I have to stand over here to ask you that.
Could you maybe repair this press, Gulliver?
I put it down.
Nate, that's a job for you, isn't it? The boy has long overtaken his old man when it comes to repairs.
That's a good boy.
That's it? Wow, you're quick. Right then, hold the fort.
We're here if you need us.
Nate has tried time and time. He.
That's all he ever says about Nate.
Every time I talk to him, I see that. Thanks to Nate, the old clay press is once again fully functional.
Okay, so you use the molten silver with this? No. I use the molten silver with something. Press a lone brick, I guess.
A perfect clay brick.
So what are we going to do with that?
You can press clay and whatever else you want into bricks. I've pressed the clay into a brick. If I were to fire it now and repeat the process a few hundred times, I'd be able to build myself a house with them. Just not sure why I'd want to do that. There's plenty of empty houses here as it is.
No, you would not want to do that. Press the sand?
I wonder if I could press the sand into some kind of brick. It's dry, and that might prevent it from sticking together very well.
Why would you want to do that?
It worked! The sand has formed a pretty solid block. Just the same, I'd better leave it in the press so that it doesn't fall apart.
Do you even know why you're doing this?
The sand forms a fairly firm, even surface in the press. I gave it a good press, and presumably that was enough to make the pieces of sand somehow latch onto one another, even though the sand is dry.
Well, I know what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to make an imprint with the crossbow bolt here, and then pour the liquid silver into there, into the imprint. So we're making a mold, pretty much. A cast, actually. I'm so clever.
A very good mold of the boat. I can't see any difference from the original. The sand now contains an imprint of the iron bolt. This looks promising.
See. Now use this with this.
This is the moment of truth.
Da-da-da.
Nate, can you carefully pour the molten silver into the sand mold without burning your robot hand things? Be careful. Very, very careful. Brilliant. Well done. There was just enough silver. The mold in the sand is filled to the brim and it's starting to cool. Now we wait.
And later.
Perfect. It looks exactly like the iron bolt, only this one will be able to inflict some damage on a werewolf as well. Now I finally got everything I need to go deeper into the woods.
Awesome.
Wish me luck.
Take care, Wilbur, and shout if you need any help.
I'm sure you'll get there in time.
The little fellow is hanging on in there. I'm sure he's trying to work out a way to help me. If you could look into that head of his. Every time I talk to him.
Alright, that's it for that. Oh, go to the place where the clay is mined. Go to the part that leads deeper into the woods. Excellent.
The clay is very moist. Ooh, perfect for making handprints or anything like that in.
We'll do that.
Probably not the right time to be thinking of messing around.
It'll only take you a second.
I've pressed the clay into a brick. Just not
Alright. Self-cast silver bolt.
I have a crossbow and a silver bolt. Now, let's hope it works against the werewolf.
And the question is, are you any good with a crossbow because you only have one bolt?
The silver bolt fits perfectly into the crossbow. I'll arm the crossbow once things get serious. I don't want to be running around the place with a loaded weapon.
I would, just in case. But that's just me. Alright. Hopefully there's nothing I need in these woods.
Whew. Okay. Time to hunt me a werewolf.
Well, now you're gonna load it. Now you're gonna walk around with a loaded weapon. Oops!
No! Be gone, you beast!
Right, he hates spiders.
Easy.
But your bolt.
Everything okay?
Has she gone?
She?
I drove it away. And I thought that I hadn't hit it.
She surprised me.
It's a female?
I hate spiders.
Everything's fine. The danger's passed. At least as long as the werewolf doesn't.
Oh boy. Oh, there's a werewolf? That little
Timmy?
Thing? Timmy's a werewolf?
Are you crazy?
Hey!
I would have got him!
All of a sudden you have a different accent. The werewolf is Timmy! You nearly shot Timmy!
That was my friend Timmy. He isn't a werewolf, he's a were-rat.
Did you know about it?
No.
He was often ill. Always became very reclusive when that happened.
Really, all this time?
Perhaps once a month, during a full moon.
Mimmy never told me how Timmy's parents died. It could have been a werewolf attack.
Wow.
Dangerous beasts. Nothing but anger, hate, and muscle. Also fur.
Yeah, that too.
Your friend shouldn't have kept it a secret from you. He would have ripped you to pieces if he'd had half the chance.
Timmy was sleeping in Esther's jacket pocket when we arrived in the dark woods. He didn't know it was always night with a full moon here. And out there in the real world, it was another 2 weeks before the full moon.
Perhaps it's not his fault, but he's dangerous. If he attacks me, I'll defend myself.
I'll find a way to break the werewolf's curse. Maybe there's a library with magic books up at the castle. The sorcerer might have been interested in werewolves. Or maybe the Count knows something. He seems very fond of wolves.
Good luck with that.
It's a stretch.
As far as I know, only a shot to the head with a silver bolt can break the curse.
It won't come to that. We'll look for Esther in the heart of the wood, and I'll take care of Timmy.
As long as he doesn't take care of us first.
Maybe there's some wolfsbane growing in here. So why would a girl like you become a bounty hunter?
A girl like you decide to become a bounty hunter?
What do you mean, a girl like me?
You know, all pretty and stuff, with purple hair.
Most gnome girls I know wouldn't choose such a dangerous career.
Yeah? Well, they'd rather be engineers, mechanics, or technicians. But what if I'm not interested in all that girly stuff?
Well, that's girly stuff.
Totally with you there. That's why I became a mage.
Well then, can't you just conjure something up and poof, the evil's gone?
Nope.
No, I'm not a mage anymore.
Oh, I think it's good that you at least gave it a try.
So you always wanted to be a bounty hunter and just did it?
And you? You always wanted to be a bounty hunter and simply followed your dream?
I wanted to help my clan. I didn't want to stand by and watch as I earn gold. We need it.
Huh.
And once you have the gold?
We'll see. Go back home. Maybe I'll find myself a handsome gnome.
Won't you miss the adventure?
Nearly being eaten by spiders? No, not particularly.
I suggest we look for the heart of the wood together, okay?
We should continue on together and watch each other's backs.
Perhaps that isn't the worst idea. I've normally got a good sense of orientation, but in these strange woods...
No problem. I got this.
What is it?
This device can tell us how close we're getting to a source of supernatural energy.
Oh, we're going to really use this now?
Genius! We just have to keep to the paths where the device reacts strongest.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Our senses can be fooled, but not good old gnome technology.
Let's go. By the way, my name is Lizzie Pebblebrook.
Lizzie
Pebblebrook? My friends call me Tin Lizzie because, well, it's quite obvious, really.
Huh. You got a new party member?
I think this thing is just leading us round in circles.
Okay, it does have an accent. She does have an accent.
Look, the heart of the woods.
Are you
wow.
Sure?
Cool. Whoops. Yeah, off the charts.
Pretty much, yep.
Peg the meter.
You have to be prepared for anything. Headless horsemen, paladins, witches, spiders. There could be a whole army waiting for us in there.
Ladies first?
Yeah. Let's look at Tin Lizzie. Look at Tin Lizzie. Look at her. Why won't that work? Look at the cave entrance.
Whatever is living in the cave under the tree, it's killed off all the trees close by. Only the tree directly above the cave entrance is alive. Well, more or less.
It's undead. Diseased tree.
I've never seen such a gnarled, sickly tree before. Even Ivo's dad will have trouble getting that to blossom again.
Right. I mean, look at her now. Interesting. It doesn't work. Just messing around. Oh, we still have the bolt.
I have a crossbow and a silver bolt. Now, let's hope it works against the werewolf.
He should be saying something different, because we know that the werewolf is really Timmy. Okay, well, nothing else, so we're gonna go in.
Well, okay then. I'll leave.
Sorry. Who's this?
Esther!
What's Esther?
Well, well, well. Who have we here?
Who have we here? Is that him? You can't be Alistair. Who are you? Let me guess. It's Munkus.
This is impossible. The Archmage is dead. Who are you?
Yes, I'm dead. Thanks to you. If you
weren't
so incompetent and stupid, I'd still be alive.
You're not Archmage Alistair.
Enough! You're not the Archmage!
Wilbur, how can you say such a thing?
Very easily.
I was your friend, and you didn't prevent my death.
Who are you, really?
Silence!
Well, hey! It's not. It's Munkus. Stop this nonsense. Who are you?
Archmage Alistair and Remy were my friends. I forbid you to pretend they're here.
Don't you understand, Wilbur? We relied on you and you have abused our trust.
Stop with the guilt trips, Munkus.
You disappointed us and you will disappoint Gulliver, Timmy, and the others too.
Thanks.
You're just a stupid little boy who makes everything worse.
Rubbish. Don't listen to him, Wilbur. No, a spider.
Yes! I will suck you dry!
Stop! I know who you are!
Munkus.
And?
You are fear?
You're always whatever we're most afraid of.
I'm death.
You're a bogger.
Disease. Loss, failure, humiliation. The monster under the bed. The creature in the cupboard.
Lizzie's afraid of spiders. Esther of the paladin who once chopped her head off. And me? I don't want to make any mistakes and cause anything nasty to happen to my friends.
It's Monkus.
But you can't prevent it. Neither of you will leave this game alive. And then I'll get your friends one by one.
Yeah. There's two of us. You are alone.
You have no chance against the two of us. Lizzie and I are a good team.
Yes.
There's actually three of us.
One of you is half petrified with fear. And the only thing keeping the other upright is the courage of desperation.
That and our awesome paper hat. You're not real.
You aren't real. Arrows and bolts just fly straight through you.
Nothing can harm me. You're lost desperately.
You only have power if we give it to you, right?
No, I am real. I will kill your friend.
Yeah? Go on then.
I will sink my fangs into your skull. Yes.
No, you won't!
Kick it.
The spider isn't real, Lizzie.
I am. Fear is real.
It can only paralyze us if we let it. Why are you backing off? Are you gonna bite her or what?
Hmm. Yes. Why should I be scared of you if you can't do anything to me?
But what if I can? You can't be sure.
Sure we can.
I'll take the risk.
Yeah.
You can't destroy me! I'm always here!
But we can control you!
Awesome.
Everything okay?
Yes. I'm all right now.
Awesome purple hair. Let's look at stuff and talk to people. Picture of a clown? Oh yeah, I didn't even see other stuff. Spider, clown, big fish, shark, and the man, Santa Claus. Doesn't look very much like Santa Claus.
A picture of a clown. Funny. A sad clown is art, everyone knows that, but this one here looks pretty normal to me.
Looks normal to you? What about the huge freaking sharp teeth?
Even though I spent quite a bit of time in Seastone, I don't know much about fish. I'm a child of the mountains. I'm pretty sure that this must be a dolphin, though, as it wants to play with a swimmer.
Oh, right. It wants to play with it.
Someone once told me that dolphins weren't actually fish at all. They were actually birds, because they flew through the water with their wings, just
birds.
Like birds through the air. Might be something to that.
Huh? And this man, who's supposedly Santa Claus?
A man waving at the observer in a friendly manner. He's wearing a name tag. Looks like his name is Claus. I don't get it. I don't like it when you really have to think to get the meaning of art. What is this Claus picture trying to tell us?
That I'm not sure. Objects here.
All sorts of small stuff and a few pieces of clothing, too. Yes, this thing fed off its victim's fear. It made them ill, perhaps even drove them mad. They were no longer able to think of anything else, didn't eat, and no one in the town knew what had happened. A little mirror, a flute, shoes, scarves, and there's a hair clip.
I'll take the lot.
Lots of little things, all mementos of the abducted villagers. I will talk to the mayor and offer to bring everything back to the village once I freed Timmy from the curse and found the sorcerer's book.
Okay. Let's talk to Lizzie.
Pretty scary, eh?
Ooh, too right. What do you think it was?
A demon? A ghost? Some headless creature that only becomes powerful when we give it power? I believe that after the sorcerer died, the people in the village were so afraid something terrible would happen that this is exactly what did happen.
And if they hadn't been so afraid, they could all still be here.
My uncle was always afraid of becoming ill. That made him ill. And if you're afraid of dying, it can make you forget how to live. You know what I mean?
You're quite the philosopher, Wilbur Weathervane.
I've just been thinking a lot how it's better to do things and maybe fail than not to do things because you're too scared to fail.
Interesting.
What are you going to do once this is over? Will you help me find the sorcerer's book?
That's your adventure. I've my own.
Oh. Actually, I think we're a good match. Well, as partners, I mean.
You got a crush, Wilbur?
You know, as partners in adventure. Adventuring partners.
He's got a crush.
Oh, I think so, too. Seastone in spring is supposed to be worth a visit.
Yeah, about that. At the moment, it's a police state run by a complete nutcase.
Pretty much.
That could be lovely. It just depends on who you're with.
And Esther.
Esther hasn't made a sound yet. I hope she's all right.
She's still scared?
And I hope she can walk. It'd be a long walk back if I had to carry her.
How could you carry her? She's like twice the size of you.
Esther, how are you doing?
He's going to cut my head off, and then I won't be able to look after Gulliver and Nate anymore.
Gulliver and Nate are fine. They're waiting for you at the campfire.
Gulliver and Nate are fine. They're both waiting for you at the campfire.
Yes, for now. But the paladin wants to chop my head off. And he'll take care of them if that happens.
Oh, the paladin. The paladin was fake. There is no paladin. He wasn't real.
There is no paladin anymore. And there never was one in the first place. It was a kind of apparition sent to scare you.
No, I definitely saw him. He is out to get my family.
That thing is gone, Esther. It can't hurt you anymore.
Don't worry, Esther. That thing is gone. It can't hurt you now.
The paladin. He wants to chop my head off. Who's going to take care of both my boys then?
Look at me, Esther. No one's going to hurt you.
Look at me, Esther. There's no one here who wants to do you any harm. The ghost has disappeared.
I knew it was a ghost, too. There were no footprints.
Gone?
It's gone. And it won't come back as long as you don't let it.
He said that he was going to get Nate. As soon as he has chopped my head off, he was going to get my little boy.
Aww.
It won't come to that. I'll explain, but not here. Let's join Nate and Gulliver by the nice warm fire, okay?
Yes. Yes. Oh, thank you, Wilbur.
Anytime. All right.
As soon as she takes Gulliver and Nate into her arms and knows that everything is okay, she'll forget this cave in no time.
All right, nothing left to do but leave.
I know two people who are longing to see you, Esther.
And I know someone who owes us a sack of gold.
Come on, let's go.
So, there was never a curse?
Nope.
That's right. No curse, no real threat. Only fear made it become a reality.
Then I'll try to be more open-minded in the future and not always assume the worst.
Well, there you go.
You can start by welcoming my zombie friends into your village.
We'll see. I'll talk to them.
Fighting for the rights of zombies everywhere. Isn't there a reward for banishing the Headless Horseman?
If my memory serves me right, you promised a sack full of gold to the person who hunted down the Headless Horseman.
Of course, and you have earned it.
Well, fork it over.
Thank you. We earned it. You get half of this, Lizzie.
Her hair looks brown now.
That won't be necessary.
Aww.
See you around.
She took the whole thing.
Oh, yes. See you later.
Oh, God, Wilbur.
I think she just, never mind.
Why were you followed by a headless horseman, of all things?
Why did fear show itself to you in the form of a headless horseman?
Oh, my grandfather always used to tell me the story about a headless horseman. I was terribly scared of it, but it was still my favorite story.
And if there's enough hysteria, you'll believe anything. Even that ghost stories are real.
Yep, can you please show me the way to the castle now?
Now you know how to defend yourself against the curse. So could you please show me the way to the old Van Buren castle?
Oh, yeah, of course. You and the enchanting young lady.
And about time, too.
That's right, sugar.
I'd better draw myself a good map. I'm sure I'll be going back and forth between the castle and the village a few more times. My friends are here, and Timmy is still somewhere in the woods.
Right.
Fine. Let's go.
End. A loading screen. Oops. Frame rate hit. What? Oh, we're catching up. Hold on.
I drew my path on the map very carefully. This way, we can always return to the village if necessary.
No need. I'll only leave the castle one more time. With a few crates of gold.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
This place sucks, don't you think?
Literally. Probably wants to suck your blood.
The castle will blossom in your presence. Just like me.
Was it a dragon head?
Daddy.
My moonshine.
That head
you
is weird.
You won't believe what I've been through. I need a bath this instant.
But of course, my love. Then perhaps a light dinner, and then let's just see what the evening holds in store. Are you her servant?
No, I.
You can be my servant. My Igor died years ago. For good this time.
Actually, I wanted
this
to...
time.
Wipe your shoes, or you'll have to clean everything again.
But...
Uh-huh.
Here we go again.
Well. Whoa, wow. Plenty of stuff to look at here. A damaged carriage.
I'd say that coach hasn't moved a meter since old Van Buren's day. Several spokes are broken. Yes. Ooh, there's a small tree growing out of one of the seats. I wonder how many owners this castle had before Van Buren. Too bad it's so run down. Soon it'll be nothing but ruins.
There's a stone.
In an old building like this, falling masonry is probably an occupational hazard. Wonder if that's why the position of Igor was open.
Could be. Lift a stone up? Can we do that?
Stone's fairly flat. Maybe some sort of roof tile. Yeah! Big white maggots.
Maggots.
Okay, if we must.
You take some maggots.
Yeah.
No reason for doing it, but we do it anyway. Ugh. Fat maggots.
Thick white grubs. For some, these things are a source of protein. I'm a little more conservative about my food.
Stop taking off your hat. What's this? Oh, Timmy's...
I must find a way to free Timmy from the werewolf curse. Once he's his old self again, I'll give him back his scarf.
I don't even remember having this. Oh, we use the grubs with the fishing pole. We can go fishing. Somewhere. Water fountain.
Legend has it that a master builder was once hired to come up with a visually appealing way to divert water from the roofs of buildings. He thought to himself, why don't I put statues on the corners of the roof and let them get rid of water the way you, well, get rid of water. The idea with the peeing statues didn't meet much approval, and they forced him to change his design. He was very angry about the whole thing. That's why gargoyles today look like they're constantly throwing up.
Is that why?
Doesn't look like rain, thankfully. A storm is the last thing I need in a place like this.
Weeds?
Nothing but weeds and trash everywhere you look. The camp really does need some urgent household support. Time to make myself useful as the new servant.
Yeah.
On the other hand, I'm not the world's best gardener and should probably leave well alone.
Hmm. We got some weeds though.
A little dandelion, bit of grass and some other weeds.
Just trying random stuff. Okay. A water bowl. For what kind of creature?
A shallow water bowl for the chickens.
Oh, chickens?
Empty.
Oh, these are chickens, yeah. I thought these were little, like, moths flying around.
They've no use for an empty bowl.
True.
A shallow bowl.
Put grubs in, no? Put weeds in? Put something in? Chicken shack. Chickens.
The Count seems to like chickens. That's a good sign. Anyone who likes animals can't be a bad person.
And so he just likes to suck their blood.
The chickens seem to be quite lively. They run, they peck. You could say they're poultry in motion.
Ugh.
The Count seems to like chicken. The chicken coop is in pretty much the same condition as the castle. Skew whiff. And the roof leaks.
What's skew whiff mean?
The castle is way, way too big for one person. Why do all rich people always buy buildings like this and live in them all alone?
That's a good question, Wilbur.
As the rooms the Count uses are so dilapidated, I wonder what the others will look like.
Okay, so letterbox. I wonder what I find in my letterbox tomorrow.
A newspaper ad, which means someone has to fight his way through the mountains on a regular basis. Just a single sealed scroll.
Awesome.
To Count Vladimir Orlov, the Dark Woods. Oh, hey, the seal bears the Seastone coat of arms.
Oh. From Lady Van Buren?
I wonder why someone would send a letter from Seastone to the Dark Woods. The letter's sealed, and it's not proper for a servant to read his master's post.
Well, you're not really his servant. You're an adventurer. Let maggots eat it. Chop it up. Put a scarf around it. Put it in the fishing pole. Put it in a bowl. Okay.
Nasty statues. I saw them from the drawbridge.
Be cool looking.
They look like a mixture of a man and bat. And it's almost as if they watch you the whole time as you approach the castle.
Maybe they are. Portcullis?
Neither the drawbridge nor the portcullis were able to protect Van Buren against the mages, paladins, and villagers who came for him. Maybe he was no longer at the height of his power. Otherwise, a sorcerer like him should be able to defend a castle like this easily.
Okay. I am going to sign off here. Thanks for watching. See you next time on a Bang Bang Boogie, and don't stop the boogie.